Hello. Back once again, finally. Got something a little special today. I tried recording this like a month and a half ago, and it just really didn't... It wasn't very good. It wasn't very good quality. We're going to be looking at a wealth scale today, and it's something I think everybody needs to see. I wanted to share it with you, so that way you can share this with everybody else. As many people as you can, because I think people need to see this. It's really mind-blowing. Because we as humans, we don't really... It's hard to just get a grasp on very, very large numbers and what they mean. And I think this scale really helps with that, so... Going to take a look real quick right here. I got some Devin Townsend going in the background, just nice music, great. Wait, let me fix this. It's been a minute, forgive me. Okay, see me in the corner right here. What's up? So, like usual, okay, I think this will be fine. Wealth shown to scale. Good. All right, let's get this started. So, sorry about that. Wealth shown to scale. We're going to be using the right directional arrow because, you know, it goes at a certain speed, and we're just going to scroll on through as far as we could. All right. So right here, starting off. Tiny little pixel here, you can see right there, that represents $1,000. To a lot of people, that, it's really, I don't know about life-changing, but it's very, it's very much a good amount of money. It certainly helped with a lot of things for me right now. Median household income in the U.S., $68,000, and this green square right here is $1 million. But look at this big blue rectangle. 1 billion compared to 1 million. That was pretty damn big, wasn't it? So if that's 1 billion right there, what's this? This long orange rectangle right here. $185 billion. It's the wealth of Jeff Bezos. So this has been updated. I remember this number used to be smaller. Because I visited this a couple months ago, and... This was not that, this number was not that big. So what does that tell you? The billionaires are just getting wealthier. I think I remember it being at like $154 billion, like maybe like a year ago. Maybe a little over a year ago. So that just means he tacked on 31 more of these blue rectangles here. So let's scroll on through, shall we? Fasten your seatbelts. I don't know why I like to say that a lot. It's just insane. So we're going along for the ride. That's why. Notice I'm still scrolling. My finger's still on the right button. Look at this. It's still going. Still going. Still going. Jeff is so wealthy that it is quite literally unimaginable. It's still scrolling. My finger's just dead set on the right arrow. We rarely see wealth inequality represented to scale. This is part of the reason Americans consistently underestimate the relative wealth of the super rich. Every 10 pixels you scroll is $5 million. Every 10 pixels. It's still going. Look at that. You see the lines down below? It's still going. Look at this. Okay, we're coming up on the end now. Thank goodness, right? All right. Lol, just kidding, we're about a third of the way. Keep scrolling though, there's more to see. You see the number pop up on the lower left-hand corner? Yeah, this is absolutely insane. Let's put this wealth in perspective by comparing it to some familiar things. Alright, what we got? All the money you will ever earn in your entire life from the day you were born until the day you die, about $1.7 million. That little tiny blue square in this giant just sea of orange, this endless sea just scrolling by. $86 billion, $87 billion. Annual cost of healthcare for a family of four, that little blue square right there that you see. Notice I haven't taken my finger off the right arrow at all. This is absolutely crazy. $94 billion, $95 billion. Annual pay of an Amazon warehouse worker? Yeah, says a lot, doesn't it? Unionize your Amazon workplace. Unionize whatever workplace you're in. Annual cost. We gotta go back. Annual cost to house every homeless veteran. This little greenish block right here. Would be the annual cost, and look at it. It's nothing in this grand orange friggin' maelstrom. 112, 113 billion. Annual cost of chemotherapy for all cancer patients, $9 billion. Had to stop right there just so I could read it in case it flew by. On July 20th, 2020, Jeff Bezos made $13 billion in a single day. Look at all this money. How can you even fathom spending this kind of money? What do you do with it? Even the fortunes of the very rich are dwarfed by the incomprehensible wealth of the 0.0001%. Wealth of Goldman Sachs CEO Dave Solomon, $50 million. Wealth of Beyonce, $400 million. Wealth of Apple CEO Tim Cook, $625 million. Lifetime earnings of a doctor on average, $6.7 million. Look at this. This little blue square right here. $6.7 million. Can you imagine having that kind of money compared to this giant orange rectangle? I'm sorry. It's literally incomprehensible. Lawyer, $4 million. Hedge fund manager on average, $84 million. These people may see themselves as fabulously rich, and I will consider them as fabulously rich as well, and often oppose policies aimed at reducing inequality. Like, they're not on this level at all. Look, $146 billion. But many have not fully grasped the enormous gulf between themselves and the super rich. Endlessly scrolling right now. Look at this. Mark Zuckerberg, $108 billion. I see. Look at that. This tiny little sliver right here. That's $200 million. This whole long black line right here is $108 billion. That's how much Mark Zuckerberg makes in a year. Or is his net worth. Whatever. Either way, absolutely insane. Jesus Christ. We can have a world in which wealthy people exist without handing nearly all money to the super rich. There's no justification for this. I've yet to hear one. How do you earn this amount of money? How do you earn that? Does Jeff Bezos just work, 185 billion times harder than his employees. No single human needs or deserves this much wealth. Finally nearing the end. 181, 182 billion. Here we go. Finally. Alright. Now for a big blue ocean of insane wealth. I don't even know if we're going to be able to get through this one. So, these little inch lines, I guess you could call them, represent $80 million. Jeff Bezos may be insanely rich, but it is a drop in the ocean. It's blue. I associate that with the ocean. compared to the combined wealth of his peers, the 400 richest Americans own about $3.2 trillion, which is more than the bottom 60% of Americans. Yeah, this is a good representation here, and you know, it's a drop in the ocean. It's blue. Humans even consistently like underestimate how big and vast the ocean is as well. Like, what, we've only explored like 3% of the world's oceans, maybe not even that. Insane. Literally unfathomable. So we're gonna try to scroll as far as we can. Look, 400 people, 400 richest Americans, $3.2 trillion. Okay, so you saw that 400, right? This is the bottom 60% of Americans. It's just, look at that. It's just endless amount of people. It's, look how fast it's scrolling too. 60%. You can even tell that even like these little figures representing people, obviously there's not 60% of Americans fitting in here. Like, you can't even do it. But 60% of Americans is what? 180 million people? Roughly? 200 million? Insane. $1 trillion is such a large figure that you might as well say 11 gajillion zillion dollars. So in this section, we will try to understand the scale of this figure while looking at what could be accomplished with various chunks of this wealth. Some will argue that using this wealth for public benefit is not possible because it's tied up in stocks and therefore inaccessible. This is just not true. And right here is... I believe if you click on this, you get this. The paper billionaire argument. And GitHub right here. M. Coral Stoff, I recommend everybody actually look at this and read this. If you actually believe, like, oh yeah, all this wealth is just tied up in stocks and whatnot, therefore you can't access it, not even true. As we proceed, try to keep in mind, all this wealth is controlled by a group so small they can all fit on a single 747 airplane with 260 seats left over. Look at that. Can you imagine? You can't. What could we do with under 10% of this money? Vaccinate every human on Earth against coronavirus. Only 6% of this wealth can be used for that. Wonder why it isn't being used for that, you know? Ask yourself that question endlessly, every day, nonstop. And ask that question to everybody else, too. Based on the cost of vaccines and the cost of delivery, it would take around $200 billion to vaccinate every person on Earth, which is about 6% of the wealth currently controlled by 400 Americans. After paying for this vaccination program, these individuals will still be $40 billion richer than they were before the pandemic. Even setting aside the desperate humanitarian need for a global vaccination, there is still a strong, self-interested argument that wealthy countries should do it. The longer COVID circulates in the world, the more chance of a vaccine-resistant variant emerging and undoing all the vaccine progress we've already made. I've made this argument myself. So, like, I know that Biden signaled that he's going to waive the he's going to support the TRIPS waiver that publicizes the patents for like the vaccines for like Pfizer, Moderna, or something, and make it so that less well-off countries or countries with little access to vaccines can develop their own generics. And that would be a giant help before COVID-19 mutates into something that literally undoes all progress that we've made in the past 15 months. The World Health Organization is currently organizing a global vaccine donation program which aims to vaccinate about 20% of residents in poor countries by the end of 2021, and even that approach has substantial funding shortfalls. Insane. Permanently eradicate malaria would mean 3% of this money. Malaria is one of the worst infectious diseases ever visited on mankind, possibly killing more people than any infectious disease in history. In the 20th century alone, malaria killed more people than the Black Death. Annual malaria deaths, 409,000. Ebola deaths in all of human history combined. Insane. These figures are even more shocking when you learn that malaria overwhelmingly kills children. Around two-thirds of malaria deaths each year are children under five. That's around 275,000 children per year needlessly dying due to malaria, and we have the money to vaccinate everyone on Earth against it. But we choose not to do it. Yeah. I can't even... Yeah, no. Mm-mm. Just keep scrolling, I guess. All of these deaths are preventable. Treating and preventing malaria is a well-understood science, universally practiced in the developed world. It is estimated that malaria could be globally eradicated by 2030 for a cost around $1.84 per at-risk person per year, or around $100 billion total. This would mean around 3% of the wealth currently possessed by the 400 richest Americans. Around 800 children will die of malaria today. A small group of super rich people could stop it for a sum of money so small that they would likely never even notice its absence, but they choose not to. This is just like I said. It's true. We could wipe out all delinquent medical debt in America for 2.5% of this wealth. Americans have about $81 billion in medical debt that is sufficiently past due as to appear on their credit report. These are generally small debts with a median value of $207 per person. These debts hinder the credit of over 50 million Americans and do long-term damage to their housing, employment, and borrowing options. The cost of repaying this debt dollar for dollar would be about 2.5% of the wealth controlled by the 400 wealthiest Americans. The situation looks even better once you understand that delinquent debt is often purchased for as little as 1% of its face value. This would make the total cost of eliminating all delinquent medical debt around $810 million. In 2020, the richest 400 Americans accrued this amount roughly every 29 hours. Absolutely insane. Excuse me. Look at this. Cost of universal buyback for delinquent medical debt. 7-day wealth increase of 400 Americans in 2020. $4.6 billion in 7 days. I guess this was per 7 days? Who knows? It's really unfathomable. Notice that this figure includes only delinquent medical debt, not all medical debt. The value of all medical debt in America is not publicly known, but probably in the neighborhood of $300 billion, or 9% of the wealth controlled by 400 Americans. Again, a drop in the bucket. 5.3% to lift every American out of poverty. As of 2021, around 38 million Americans lived in poverty. If Americans in poverty were a state, they would be second largest by population, just behind California. There are more Americans living in poverty than the entire population of Canada. Jesus. I honestly can't believe that. Yeah, look at that. Unfriggin' believable. Every single person in America could be lifted above the poverty line with a one-time cash subsidy of around $10,000 per impoverished family, and about $7,000 for impoverished individuals. The total cost would be $170 billion, a little over 5% of the wealth currently controlled by 400 individuals. Wow, another chart, 88 pages, census.gov, content, damn, census library publications, P60-266, I mean, we have the figures for this, folks, we have the data, we have the studies, it's all there, this whole scale wasn't made for nothing. It may seem counterintuitive that a one-time subsidy could have any lasting impact on chronic poverty, but one of the surprising truths about poverty is that it's fluid. Americans move in and out of poverty many times throughout their lives, and one good year can have a massive and long-lasting effect. A wealth of data now supports the idea that one-time cash transfers can permanently transform a local economy. Given the sudden windfall, people invest in their future. They go back to school, obtain transportation, pay for childcare, pay down debilitating debts, and do any number of things to improve their career prospects and financial future. We could do this. I feel like pushed enough, the Democrats would do it, but their excuse is always Republicans. That's why we need to abolish the Republican Party. Because they'll never go along with anything like this. They'll actually care about lifting people out of poverty. And they always point to, oh, what about the debt? Oh, what about the deficit? The past six or seven presidents, you look at maybe like the past 10 presidents, you look at Republicans versus Democrats, every single time, Republicans leave office with a deficit. Democrats, I don't know if they leave with a surplus, but the deficit is shrunk, like, by a giant amount. And they say Democrats are not fiscally responsible. I'm not a fan of the Democrats, but anyway. A wealth of data now supports the idea that one-time cash transfers, okay. Already read this. In the U.S., for all the people that escape poverty in any given year, about half stay out of poverty for at least 5 years afterwards. About a third are still out of poverty 10 years later. This would not be a permanent fix for all Americans. Surely some would quickly return to poverty, and others face debt so large that the subsidy would make little difference. But for tens of millions of Americans, this would be a life-changing event. It would be a generation-defining social program that reshapes our economy for decades to come. And we can do it. (sighs) 7.5% provide clean drinking water and toilet access to every human on Earth. Around 844 million people have no access to clean water of any kind. About the same number have no access to a toilet or a latrine of any kind and therefore defecate in the open. Look at that. No clean water. Contaminated water is a major source of disease, including cholera, dysentery, and typhoid. It is estimated that contaminated water kills about 829,000 people every year, making it one of the world's biggest killers. The cost to provide clean water and waste disposal for everyone on Earth would be about $240 billion, or 7.5% of the wealth controlled by the richest 400 Americans. Okay, now that we've established the scale of inequality in the United States, let's dare to dream a little bigger. What could we do with under 40% of this money? Provide paid maternity and maternity leave. Sorry. This is getting overwhelming for me at this point. Provide paid maternity and paid maternity and paternity leave to every American for the next 100 years. 39.6% of this wealth. Paid maternity and paternity leave are estimated to cost around $12 billion per year. This is 0.39% of the wealth controlled by 400 Americans. It is 5% of the wealth they accrued in 2020 alone. This is a more complex program to estimate than the others considered on this page, because the expense would be continuous rather than one time, and the cost is highly variable based on the size of the benefit provided. Still, using the 5% endowment payout rule, the super wealthy should be able to finance a family leave program about 12 times more generous than the one contemplated here forever, and still get richer into perpetuity, even accounting for inflation. This is insane. This is beyond insane. For 40%, give $10,000 to every American household, as we just went over. There are about 128 million households in the United States. To give each one $10,000 would cost $1.28 trillion, or about 40% of the wealth controlled by 400 Americans. It all comes down to greed. As the coronavirus raged through America in 2020, working people were frequently presented with a seemingly impossible choice between death by premature reopening and an economic depression brought about through a continued quarantine. Remember? I'm sure you do. Unspoken in this false choice was the supposition that Americans could not pay their living expenses without either work or unsustainable government deficit spending. Where else could the money have possibly come from? Think about it real hard. We're only at $110 billion out of $3.2 trillion. What could we do with 60% of this money? How far are we? 28 minutes. All right, so we're at $110 billion. We might have to do a part two of this because, like I said, this is beyond insane. It's incomprehensible. It's... Okay. Yeah, we're not even... I don't even think we're like 5% into this. No, we're not. We're not even 5% into $3.2 trillion. It goes on forever. I've been scrolling and stopping just to read this. I think it needs to be edited. But then again, they might just have so many things that we could fit in $3.2 trillion that it's like, okay, stop and read this, or maybe not. Either way, I think we're gonna have to stop here. maybe in the future, soon enough, I'll try to get through the rest of this and make a part two. But for now, thank you so much for watching. Share this with as many people as you can. It's important that people understand just how mindlessly insane this is. If you're new here, subscribe. Be sure to like and comment. Let me know what you think. Follow me on Twitter at Stateless Patriot. I'll see you guys in the next video as soon as possible. Thank you guys for watching.